Hey ladies and gentlemen, Steven here from Redolescence. Welcome back to another video. Thank you so much for joining me today. I really do appreciate your time and your viewership. It means a lot. In today's Cephalobond contributor review, where you do have the opportunity to win a full-size bottle of Zherzhov perfume, I'm going to be going over my top 10 favorite fragrances from the brand Zherzhov. And I'll be honest with you, I have many favorites, but I tried to curate this list so that I can talk about some of the fragrances that I see myself wearing in the autumn season, because the weather is starting to get a little bit cooler outside. I know autumn officially starts on September 22nd. I'm going to be letting you know why I enjoy these so much, so make sure to stay tuned. Now, before I begin this video of my top 10 favorite Zherzhov fragrances, or I should say some of my favorites, because I do have a lot of Zherzhov fragrances in my collection. I've been acquiring them for the past 10 years. I do want to mention that if you are a fan of fragrance-related content, if you like top 10 videos like this, but also reviews, giveaways, unboxings, and more, please do consider supporting this channel by subscribing to it. And of course, if you can take the time to give this video a thumbs up for the YouTube algorithm, it would really mean a lot to me. And of course, if you would like to enter for your chance to win a full-size bottle of a Zherzhov perfume, thanks to Cephalobond in this Cephalobond contributor video, all you have to do is shoot on over to cephalobond.com. I'm going to leave the link to the specific article down below. Make sure to read through the article. You must be a registered reader, and then make sure to leave a comment below the article based off of the criteria stipulated in the article, and then the winner will be announced on cephalobond.com. Good luck to everybody out there. Make sure to participate. Make sure to enter the giveaway while it is still valid, because we know that Zherzhov fragrances are some of the best and some of the more expensive fragrances in the niche perfume industry. So you want to make sure to enter for your chance to win potentially a very expensive bottle of perfume. And these are ones that I absolutely love. I have purchased so many of them throughout the years. And I initially discovered this brand back in 2011 when I was at a perfume boutique in Manhattan. And I just remember being in olfactory heaven, so diverse, from the shooting stars to the oud stars. I've also had the opportunity to meet one of the chief perfumers behind the brand, Chris Maurice, when he visited here in Atlanta, Georgia, and I was over there for a conference, but I also flew over to Spain a couple of times, and I had the opportunity to meet him at his perfume factory and laboratory. So let's go ahead and start this video. I'm excited to kick it off with the number 10 spot. And this is a fragrance from the Shooting Stars collection. And this one is called Dajala. Now, the reason I love this one so much is because it's floral and it's citrusy, but it's incredibly long lasting. This is such a potent fragrance. And I've had this in my possession for close to 9 years now, if I'm not mistaken. It was one of my first purchases from the brand, not my first purchase. I'll let you know what that is in just a second. But this one contains African orange flower in addition to a bunch of citrus ingredients. So it's citrusy, it's very easy to wear, but the potency of this blend allows me to wear it even when the weather gets a little bit colder outside, when I still want to smell very fresh, give off that exotic appeal to the aroma. Dajala by Zherzhov is an amazing fragrance, one that I've been enjoying for nearly a decade now. The next fragrance that I want to talk about is from the Oud Stars collection, and it's really amazing when you purchase one of these fragrances because they come with this exquisite presentation, usually containing a meteorite inside for a lot of them. I mean, if you've seen a box for a Zherzhov perfume up close, you see all the minutiae and the detail that really makes it the exquisite product that it is, and the luxury product at that. This was actually my first purchase ever, and so it has a very sentimental place in my heart. This one is called Alkat. This has agarwood, but it also has one of the most authentic jasmine ingredients that I've ever smelled in my life. And the reason I say that is because the jasmine in here is quite indolic. And whenever you find a jasmine note that possesses that indolic quality, you know it kind of gives off this animalic prowess, if you will, but that allows it to smell that much more organic, that much more natural. And I absolutely love Alkat. It also happens to be one of those fragrances where just a few sprays go such a long way, and they will follow you throughout the course of the entire day. Of course, there are some other fragrances from Zherzhov that I think have stunning longevity and performance, including Gao, including Najaf and Zanzibar, but Alkat happens to be one of my favorites for very good reason. The next fragrance that I want to talk about is one that is also very special. You've actually seen me mention this in a few of my videos, and this is a flanker, if you will. And so the original Uden is a fragrance that I really like. It contains tobacco blossom, but Uden Overdose is exactly that. It's an overdose. It's a powerful fragrance. And of course, let me show you the bottle. And this one contains bergamot, lemon, tobacco blossom, and ginger. So you have this really sparkling quality on account of the ginger that serves to spice things up a little bit, but in a very flavorful and a very easy to wear and accessible way. And so it pairs with the citrus very, very nicely. And of course, the tobacco blossom does have some of those inherent floral properties. And I think that that also accentuates or improves the accessibility of the formula as well. Perfectly unisex. I really love this. As a matter of fact, every single fragrance in this list is unisex. And so wear them with pride, wear them with pleasure. The next fragrance that I want to talk about is another fragrance from the Oud Stars collection. And of course, all of these fragrances contain natural oud in them. The fragrance that I'm talking about today is Mamluk. And if you just take a look at my bottle, you can see that I have worn quite a bit of this. And so I'm quite an aficionado for Mamluk by Zerzhov. This is a caramel and oud fragrance. And so it's really interesting because it veers and ventures into gourmand territory, but it's not a sugary sweet composition. You still have enough of that natural agarwood in the base to sort of tame things up. And the combination of the sweet and the woodsy profile really coalesces and congeals to create something that is so abundantly perfect, in my opinion. I really, really love Mamluk. One of my first purchases, not my first, like I said, Alcott was my first, but Mamluk was probably my second or third purchase when I started to explore some of the Oud Stars fragrances. And of course, I fell in love with Mamluk. I knew I had to get it sooner rather than later. The next fragrance that I want to talk about is actually a recent acquisition of mine, and this was provided to me for review. And when I did my review of this fragrance, I fell head over heels in love. I had worn it for a significant amount of time before I committed to reviewing it. And I love the powerful nature of this perfume, incredibly long lasting, fantastic projection. And this one is called Apollonia. Now, of course, this is a dedication to the Apollo 11 mission, and with Apollonia, you have these starchy white florals. There is a nice bit of iris in here. It's not a lipsticky iris per se, but the iris is incredibly long-lasting, and you have a combination of some other floral ingredients too, perhaps a little tuberose, maybe some other clean white florals, maybe a little bit of jasminol to sort of clean things up as well. Such a stunning and intriguing perfume, and one of my favorites of all time. I really got to be honest with you there. I absolutely love Apollonia, and I think it's also incredibly versatile. It's the type of DNA I can see myself wearing a lot in the spring, but because of how strong it is, I can see myself wearing it all year round as well. So I will be honest, I cannot make a top 10 favorite Zerzhov perfume list without mentioning this fragrance. This fragrance is absolutely exquisite. Of course, it happens to be one of my favorite summer perfumes. And this one is Mephisto Gentiluomo. Now, I prefer this to the original Mephisto, which is also a great composition. But with Mephisto Gentiluomo, you have the citrus in the opening, you have the rose that's in here, you have the violet, you have a little bit of that irisy quality happening in here. So it's a really nice harmonious balance of the citrus ingredients and the floral ingredients. And Mephisto Gentiluomo is also incredibly easy to wear. If you had to ask me for my opinion on it, I would say the two easiest to wear Zerzhov fragrances in this list are probably Uden Overdose and Mephisto Gentiluomo. Of course, once you start getting into the Oud Stars fragrances, you do have to be a bit of a connoisseur. You do have to have a proclivity towards the note of oud, but Mephisto Gentiluomo is a Swiss Army knife. It's so easy to wear. I love how bright and vibrant and effervescent it is. One of my favorite fragrances of all time, not just from the Zerzhov catalog and library, but it happens to be one of my favorite fragrances of all time. The next fragrance that I want to talk about is a classic in the Zerzhov lineup. It's one that you often hear people mentioning online, in editorials, and of course, it receives as much praise as it does for very good reason. And it also happens to be a fragrance that a lot of other brands have taken influence from. And this one is Herba Pura. Herba Pura is an amazing fragrance that was originally released under the Sospiro name. And of course, it is under the Zerzhov umbrella. So now you will see Zerzhov on the cap. but this is a fruity fragrance with a touch of vanilla, and you kind of have like these melon qualities in the opening, a little bit of cantaloupe, you have a little bit of melon, honeydew. I'm not entirely sure. I don't think the specific melon or fruity notes are listed, but you do have this cocktail of fruits in the opening, and also the performance on it is exquisite. I don't think I've ever smelled a single Zerzhov fragrance that provided me with lackluster performance. They are all way above average, and that's another thing that people really love and admire about this brand. The next one that I want to talk about is the strongest fragrance in this entire list. One or two sprays will follow you 12 plus hours. Many of you probably already know what it is just by me mentioning it. And of course, this also happens to be one of my earlier purchases from the brand. The moment this collection was announced, I took a trip to a local perfume boutique and I purchased this one. And this one is from the Join the Club collection, and it's called More Than Words. Always reminds me of that song, More Than Words. But this one, I get a lot of patchouli. It's not listed as a note, surprisingly, but this is an amazing combination of resins and vanilla and fruity notes and some spicy notes in there as well. And every single time I wear this one, I do get compliments from it. It happens to be one of my most complimented fragrances. People have stopped me on the street before, one time when I was returning home from the supermarket, and the gentleman who was working at a nearby mechanic shop, he actually asked me to write this fragrance down. When I told him the price, he said forget about it. But I really love More Than Words. Such an amazingly well put together fragrance. And of course, this is yet another fragrance that has inspired a few brands that have succeeded its release. The second to last fragrance that I want to talk about is the fragrance in my number one spot. And this is a fragrance that, of course, I acquired many years back, and it is a few years old. And I love this one because it's also gourmand leaning, but it has enough woodsy nuances to sort of tame it and ground it. It has cinnamon in here, you have vanilla in here, you have amber in the base that creates this warm yet exotic vibe to the perfume. And this one is called Overture. And another thing that I should probably mention at this point is that you may have noticed that a lot of my Zerzhov fragrances do possess the older presentation. And that's because I purchased a lot of these right when they came out. And it was one of these niche brands that really opened up my world of perfumes to discovering a lot of the more dark and experimental niche perfumes on the market. And Zerzhov is such a solid way to go in terms of diversifying your olfactive library, at least the one in your head, right? And familiarizing yourself with many DNAs on the market. And of course, the number one fragrance that I want to talk about before I reveal it, I do want to give some honorable mentions because I know I'll probably get crucified if I don't mention these. Neo is one of my favorite fragrances of all time. Love wearing that one in the summertime. 1861 Renaissance is also one of my favorites of all time. Love wearing that one in the summertime. And perhaps the only really summer-driven perfume in this list has been Mephisto Gentiluomo, but I find this to be one of those good intermediary fragrances on account of the woods and the florals that allows me to wear it into the fall season as well. I know there's a lot of love for Naxos. I personally love one of the more underrated fragrances like Guarda Sina. I also love Accento Overdose. You may have seen me do a review of Amabile recently as well. So there's a lot of Zerzhov fragrances that I do love, and I have to throw those honorable mentions out there. But my number one current favorite fragrance, I wore this fragrance yesterday. I couldn't stop smelling myself. Just a combination of the apple, the cinnamon, the rose, the vanilla, the palisandre rosewood. This is so complex, it's so intriguing. It has some sweet nuances, some spicy nuances, some floral nuances. It goes in a few different directions, but it's pieced together so masterfully by the master perfumer, Chris Maurice from Barcelona, Spain. And this one is Alexandria 2. Now, I know this fragrance also has a few flankers. There's also the Orientale version. I'm talking specifically about Alexandria 2. It's one of those fragrances where I had gone a very long time without smelling a new Zerzhov fragrance. Of course, I've smelled Golden Mocha and Golden Dala, and I've smelled a lot of the newer releases, but I took a short break from Zerzhov while I was exploring some other brands. And then going back into it, I said, oh yeah, I've been hearing a lot about Alexandria too. And so I have first smelled this one several years ago. And the moment I smelled it, I immediately fell in love. And I said, I need to get my hands on a bottle of this fragrance. And again, like I mentioned earlier in the beginning of this video, I tried my best to curate this list so that as we enter the autumn season, you are familiar with some of the heavier fragrances from the brand, perhaps not super heavy, that you can wear it in the winter time. But I think this one, especially Overture, Erba Pura, More Than Words, are all fantastic for the autumn when you want something with a little bit of oomph in it, when you want something that's a little bit darker, something that's going to carry you through the quickly getting colder conditions of the autumn. So thank you so much for joining me today. I really hope you took something of value from this top 10 video. Once again, a very special thank you to Seph Laban for hosting a full bottle giveaway. Once again, if you would like to enter for your chance to win, I'm going to be leaving all of the information down below to the article. Make sure to visit sephlaban.com. Read the article. You must be a registered reader. Of course, make sure to read through all of the stipulations of the article very carefully. And then once you leave your comment below the article, you will be automatically entered for a chance to win. And make sure to go back to sephlaban.com on the date that is specified on the article to find out if you are the winner of the giveaway. Good luck to everybody out there. Also, leave a comment down below in this video. Let me know, what is your favorite Zerzhov fragrance? If you've had the opportunity to try a bunch of Zerzhov fragrances, if you have not, tell me which one of the fragrances in this list sounds the most appealing to you, or sounds like the one that would cater the most to your personal tastes. Thanks again for watching. Love you all. We'll see you next time. Bye.